Harvey Storm here. So today's video, I don't know what today's video is going to be about. I was going to do another tarot card reading. Nobody really told me how last time went, but I'm just going to say some people liked it. I got some thumbs up. And I did want to talk, I wanted to comment on, just what's going on. You know, we are in a major shift. We have been for a long time, and I've been talking about it before I even knew this was how it was going to manifest. I knew something big was coming, and I know that there's the shift from 3D to 5D that is going on, and that's scientifically proven. Like, that's a science thing. The frequency of the planet is accelerating, and basically we're going to a higher frequency, which is a higher state of consciousness. And we are going to be in under new paradigms that serve humanity better. And that's why all the old constructs that do not serve humanity are being dismantled. The coronavirus, I believe, is part of this. It's divine intervention in a certain way. It's, I don't know. I just know that it's supposed to happen. I do think it's been manipulated. I do think that there's definitely some shady stuff going on in there with our leaders and with our sponsors for certain things, but and I just don't trust them. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I usually don't have these feelings about certain things, but our government's, you know, not trustworthy, period. I mean, that's not conspiracy theory. That's just having common sense. I mean, they've always been up to stuff. That's the way the whole freaking government works. That's the purpose, like, is to manipulate and control people, right? That's why we have a government. I mean, it's not supposed to be ugly, but it's going to be. When you're talking about power, it's going to be. Power and money. It's going to be manipulation involved. So I'm wanting to share with you guys something that I've noticed that it concerns me. As you know, that I've shared with you my beliefs on spirituality and my beliefs on how manifestation occurs. And I believe we are all one consciousness that are basically sprayed out into different, our own little rays of God, that we are having a personal experience of a collective consciousness. That collective consciousness is what creates the world that we live in. And our individual consciousness is what creates our experience of that world. And I know that there's all this, there's just a lot of duality, polarization, and I'm seeing human beings act really, really childish, really, really ugly to one another over silly things. I mean, I know that the coronavirus is going around and people are afraid, but do you guys not realize that the media pumps that on purpose? They pump you full of fear. I'll hear the media for 5 minutes and have to turn it off because it makes me sick. It makes me sick. It's diabolical the way they do it. They want you fearful. And I've done, you know, I did some research, and it all, it's designed that way. It's designed that way. So, you know, the news sources all go back to the same group of people. And they control the narrative, and the narrative is split on purpose to keep us polarized. Because if we are fighting with each other, then they can do their thing, and we're too busy fighting with each other. And then when we're so busy fighting and we're getting ugly and nasty, and then they have to roll out a mandatory whatever rule. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Order, you know, like the stay home order and whatever. then we accept it because we're all fighting and nobody can make up their mind and, you know, blah, 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 blah. I don't know. We're just so distracted that we're not really paying attention to what's going on and really paying attention to the fact that this could be a problem. If we continue to just let them do what they want and agree with them because we're being brainwashed by multimedia, that's isn't that how the Holocaust happened? I'm not trying to be all negative. I'm just trying to alert people because I don't want to spread fear either. I don't, and I'm not fearful. I mean, I am with our attitudes, with our, you know, our beliefs, with our compliance. We control what the world creates. So, I think that we all need to start connecting with one another. I think that we all need to stop fighting with one another. Stop it. If somebody doesn't have your point of view, that doesn't mean they're the devil. They just don't share your point of view. Their experiences in life were different. Their perspective is different. How things affect them is different. Just respect another human being. They don't have to think like you, okay? I know that feels like, oh, but then this is gonna happen, this is gonna happen. No, if everybody's being respectful and everybody's loving one another and everybody's united, nothing but good things are gonna happen. Nothing but good things. Because positive energy attracts positive energy and negative energy attracts negative energy. So the more we're fighting, the more we're gonna have to fight. The more we're loving, the more loving this world becomes. Period. That's just all. It's that simple. So that's what I got on that, people. That's my little, you know, knock it off speech. Because, and I'm not going to lie, I can get, you know, triggered. I'm human. So, but social media is a very, very... I'm not sure it's a good thing, really, honestly. There are positives to it, like you can stay in touch with people that you wouldn't be able to otherwise, but it's very easily, it can hijack you, basically. Pretty easily, you know what I mean? Like, you can get sucked in without even knowing it. So, be aware of that. Be aware that it's a social media site. Like, it's not real. It's not real. That's not a world. Because people act on social media differently than they would act in person. They say things that they wouldn't say. They are hostile, you know. And that's part of the problem with the social media. There's bullying, even with adults. There's cyberbullying. And there's cyberbullying of dead men. I mean, like, people were sharing George Floyd's criminal record. So we're gonna chastise a dead, I mean, seriously? Really? That's where we're at right now? What are we doing? So there's that, and then now some man that wouldn't wear a mask died, and people are ridiculing him publicly by sharing his story and going, ha ha, he didn't wear a mask and now he's dead. Really? Think about that. Think about that. Not acceptable. Not okay. That's not how humanity should be treating one another. Okay? He could have got the freaking disease and died anyways. Because God's the one that's in charge. He could have worn a mask diligently and washed his hands and never left his house and still got it and died. So don't ridicule a dead person. They're not here to defend themselves. It's just ugly. So that's my kick you in the butt. Speech, and let's do our reading. So, what do we want to talk about today? What do we want to ask Spirit? Spirit, let's just ask you again the same question we asked you last time. And that is, what messages do you have? And the angels, what messages do you have for my viewers, myself, anybody who these messages might reach? that we need to know that will help us in the world, that will help us navigate through this dimensional shift into a new, beautiful reality that we create that is darn near perfect. We can have that. We can have anything we want. We just have to manifest it. We just have to put our point of focus there. We need to focus on it, think about it, imagine it. If you can see it in your, if you can see it in your mind, you can have it in your hand. Basically, if you can visualize it, you can create it. Your visual, your actual, the process of visualizing it is manifesting it. That's how you manifest. You put your, you have a vision, and then you put your heart into it, because the heart is the most powerful force. And you put your heart into it by feeling the feelings that you would feel if those things happened. How would you feel? When you emit that frequency, it attracts it. And there's a quote by Einstein. I'll try to put it on here so you can see. But it's something to do with if you match your frequency to the frequency of any reality, your reality is, you're going to experience that reality. There's no other way. And it's not philosophy. It's not woo-woo. It's not, it's freaking physics. So, let's create an awesome one. And if you don't want to, fine. I'm going to create an awesome one. I'm, you know, devoted to it. And, you know, we're in retrograde too, which is making a lot of old things come up. You know, it's kind of like the final exam with God, like all your crap that you've, for me, all the crap that I've healed over the past year or so is showing, it's rearing its ugly head. And I'm going, wait a minute, I thought we resolved this. I thought we healed this. But it's just like, you know, checking up on it, seeing if I can do better. So angels, spirit, what messages do you have for us? Oh, there's two there. One, two, three, four, five, a beautiful rose quartz. Five. Six. Number one is, I'm pretty sure, what is the physical situation? The physical, I don't want to call it a problem, but the physical issue is what it says. So what is the physical issue? It is sexuality. Interesting. You know how I was talking about polarization? Well, that makes me think of the sex, the sexes, the genders, the opposite genders, because they're polar opposites. They have opposite energies. And in order for you to be a balanced person, you gotta have the balanced masculine and feminine energy within yourself. Here, let's read what the representative of this card is. I'm here. Sexuality is the physical expression of our soul's essence. It is the part of us that connects us to the physical world. I always say that God convinced us to come here with sex and food. That was the reward of coming here, because it's a nightmare here, is it not? It is the part of us that connects us to the physical world. Sexual energy connects us to our bodies and inspires us to express ourselves through use of our bodies, through clothes, makeup, body art, and dance. It is through the senses that we develop sensitivity on the levels. Through touch, sight, sound, smell, and taste, we awaken to the richness of life. It is through pleasure that we celebrate life, and through ecstasy that we experience oneness with divinity and the nature of the divine. This may be a time for you to begin exploring becoming sensitive to yourself. Have you been honoring your body and your sexuality as sacred? Does your physical being reflect and express your spiritual being? Do you allow yourself to feel sensitive and awake inside your body? Do you feel free to express yourself physically and sexually? This is a time of reflecting on these questions and bringing balance, which is what I was talking about, to this area of your life. If you have a relationship that needs healing in this area, or are you are wanting to bring in a new partner, you must first heal the balance and balance these things within yourself. What did I just say? Others will ever reflect the true and often hidden feelings you have about yourself. So, and that's what I was talking about in the last video. What you see, what reflects back to you from somebody else is your shortcomings. That's what you see, because that's what you are calibrated with, you know? Therefore, this is the time to love yourself, explore your sensuality, become sensitive, honor your body as sacred, and enjoy your sexuality. I think that sex is a spiritual experience. And I think that our society has made it shameful, or, I don't know, there's just sort of like a shameful thing that is tagged on it, and I think that that's just like the religion stuff, and I don't know. I don't think it's supposed to be like that. I think it's sacred. I really do. I do think that there are certain aspects that could not quite be what Jesus would do, but you know, for the most part, it's a good thing. This card is representing the duality that I'm talking about, finding the balance. We are out of balance right now, people. So the next one is water, how it affects your emotions. Special message, guardian angel. How does this affect your emotions? Okay, guardian angel. The angel that comes to you now is your own personal guardian angel, and the message you must receive can only come from within. If you have drawn this card, introspection is needed. The answers you seek exist within your own heart. Take the time now to sit and really listen to what it is in your inner voice is saying. Trust your own heart and follow it. This is the time to listen to your own truth above all other outside influences. Your guardian angel will speak to you in your heart now, and your heart will show the way. Note, for the information on how to receive messages from your guardian angel, see the section on communicating with the angels. You can communicate with your guardian angel just by closing your eyes and asking yourself a question. You will get a gut feeling. And whatever that gut feeling is the answer to the question. That's where God talks to you. That's where your angels talk to you. Right there. This says heart, and I get that, because we're all connected in the heart too. But for me, when I am receiving a message, it comes to me as a gut feeling. So, your angels have messages for you, people. We need to be listening to our own truths and not worrying about what other people's truths are. It's none of our business. What their soul path is, what their soul journey is, what their soul lessons are, how they experience the world is none of our business. Now, I bring up the stuff because A, I don't want people to suffer, and B, I don't want the collective to suffer or to be disabled in some way, or just, you know, like, I want things to work out the best way possible. So that's why I want to, you know, make people aware of stuff, but it's real. I can't change anybody's mind. And you know, if you're debating and going back and forth with facts and blah, 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 nobody knows really what's real anyways. We don't even know if we're real. We could be avatars. So be careful, because you don't know any more than anybody else, and I don't know any more than anybody else. And that's where we come to the thing about turn within, and your truth is your truth, and nobody can shake it. There are no statistics, facts, nothing can shake your truth. If it's in your gut and that's you and you, don't listen to anybody else. Okay? You know, you have the answers to every single thing. It's inside of yourself. So I would recommend meditation. That's how I connect. So that's what I got on that. The next one, air how the issue affects your thoughts. Hopefully we'll start moving faster. The shadow self. Good stuff. That's good stuff. The shadow self is a good thing, because you got to heal your shadows, or you cannot evolve. You cannot move forward. You're carrying baggage. Your shadows are basically your hidden wounds that your hidden whatever is shameful or hurt or anything that's negative that you hold, because you store trauma in your body, and I mean it can turn into cancer. That's what cancer is. It's, you know, you manifest it with your maladjustment to whatever the situation is, or your inability to come to terms with it or accept it. Or so you need to look at your shadow self and just confront your shadows, own them. What was I talking about the other day? I was talking to a friend and I said, oh, we were debating and something came up, and he made me feel like I was stupid. And so I said that. I said, well, I'm not stupid. Don't talk to me like I'm stupid. And I was like, well, I'm dumb. He said, well, then we got into a thing about what's the difference between stupid and dumb and ignorant. He said, I'm not dumb in any area. I said, oh, you know ballet? And he was like, no, I'm ignorant in ballet, but I'm not dumb in any area. And I was like, okay, well, and I was getting ready to say, I'm not dumb in any, and then I was like, no, okay, I'm dumb in two areas. I'm dumb with men, and I'm dumb with directions, just straight up. Because I'm armed with the facts, but I still do stupid shit. So that's me owning my shadows, okay? That's the best I can do for now anyways. So, heal those shadows. Next one, fire. What you may need to surrender to move forward. Prosperity. Get off the status stuff. Get off the money stuff. Get off the righteousness and status quo. Like, none of that, it matters. It does not matter. Nobody cares what your status is, how much money you have, because it's just not important. I mean, we all have to survive. I understand that, but you're not superior to anyone because you have more money, or because you have more prosperity, or because so you're gonna, we all as people need to surrender our need to be prosperous in the eyes of the world, okay? Be prosperous for yourself. Be successful with yourself. Be true to yourself. Because we spend our whole lives living for everybody else. We make our whole choices about, not on what will make us happy, is what will they think. Think about that. The next one is spirit, what lies in your heart. Intuition. That's where it all comes from. That's what I was just talking about. Turn within. I don't need to say much, do I? Because I pretty much already covered it. Turn within. But your heart is where your intuition is. Turn within. Please be aware of, you know, I think a lot of the fighting and stuff is people just not being aware. They're just getting sucked into they're being sucked into the drama, sucked into the illusion, sucked into the narrative of what we're supposed to believe. And you're being a puppet to the government. So, I mean, I don't want to be that. So I would want somebody to make me aware of that. If you don't believe that, then that's fine. You don't have to believe that. Maybe you're black. The fact that you don't believe that will make you not experience that. I'm aware, you know, but I'm also aware that I believe what I believe. And I mean, I can try really hard to not believe that. I just got to keep my point of focus of what I want, you know? So that's how you do that, is you keep your focus on what you want, not what you lack. The last card. This is the culmination of all the cards. Unbelievable, people. Unbelievable. Unfreaking believable. This is why, when people are name calling and people are acting foolish, I continue to communicate. I continue to leave a dialogue available, because we have to communicate to unite. We have to understand each other. And every single difference that we have is basically a misunderstanding. If it's rooted in, you know, the foundation of who we are, even if it's that big of a, you know, thing that you disagree on, it's because of your upbringing. It's because of your experience. It's because of your background. It's not because, you know, we're all one. So if you could just maybe stop and look at the other person from their angle, maybe they experience things differently than you. Maybe things will affect them. I think I've already gone over this. So, and we have to communicate. We have to understand each other. So stop, you know, running people off with being mean, and be nice. There's a story, there's a TED talk about a black man that requested to meet with the leader of the KKK. He didn't understand racism, and he wanted to learn about it. So he set up a meeting, and they talked. He said the KKK obviously didn't know that he was going to be black, but he sat and talked with him and answered his questions, and basically answered that his beliefs stem from, you know, his upbringing and what was instilled in him while he was growing up. And he also said that nothing is going to change that. Like, there's nothing that will change his mind. That is what his belief is. He said whites are superior to blacks, and there's nothing you can say that's going to change my mind. The black man didn't get all crazy and start name calling. The black man didn't. He just said, why? You know, he just kept the dialogue open without getting personal. You know what happened? They became best friends over time. They kept meeting. One of the KKK guy invited the black man to his rally so that he could see for himself what goes on. It made the news. The news interviewed the KKK leader. And by the end of the, you know, what the outcome was, is that the man that was the leader of the KKK turned over his uniform and left the organization. And learned that a black man is his equal, and learned that, and he even says, it shows him saying, this man here has shown me more respect than any of you all. So it's amazing how far you can get by showing somebody respect. You could maybe get somebody to leave the KKK by showing them respect. The people who deserve it least are the people who need it most. Just remember that. That's all I got for today. Have a good day.
The earth has faced evil since the beginning of time, and fear is the evil that plagues humankind. It's perched in the dark corners, not easy to find, It hides in the shadows and hopes you are blind. And people, they miss it, they often can't see, as it spreads like an invisible enemy. It hijacks our thoughts, shakes reality. Fear consumes us almost instantly. But lest we forget who holds all the power, it's not some vaccine or some new 5G tower. He's stronger than they are, he makes demons cower. Some call him father of all that is ours. Don't feed fear into Lucifer's fire. Don't feed it fury, sadness, or ire. Feed it contentment, though not its desire. This world's what we make it, hell or empire. Because the kingdom of God is not in the sky. It dwells in our consciousness deep down inside. You can't catch a virus inside your mind, so don't let them fool you, because trust me, they'll try. Stop watching TV obsessed with the news. It's brainwash, I tell you. You can't see the clues. Nothing can harm us, can't even subdue. The news has a motive, and that's to scare you. Because something awaits us beyond what we know. It's past this illusion, this 3D shit show. It's here with us now, waiting for us to grow. So vamanos, amigos. Come on, let's go.